It's as different as chalk and cheese. That's a very well-known expression, but a curious expression. Why don't we say it's as different as bicycles and bananas? What I'd like to do in this video is talk about the four fundamental concepts that we need to understand in order to understand ecology and the diversity of communities. And I'm going to illustrate that with chalk and cheese. So first of all, one of the main concepts is understanding soil types. This is what's called a rendzina. It's characteristic of chalky habitats. You can see the chalk underneath. And a rendzina is a very thin, shallow layer of well-drained soil, low in organic matter. It's high in calcium carbonate. It's dry, pretty infertile. So it's a pretty challenging habitat for species to grow in. The second element is the underlying geology, and you get rendzinas where you get chalk habitats. And if you, with some imagination, you might be able to see over there, there's the spire of Salisbury Cathedral. And in Salisbury Market, there used to be two groups of farmers. There'd be the farmers from the chalk up here that would bring in their sheep, and there'd be the farmers from the clay areas over to the west who would bring in their cattle and their milk and their cheese. So these two kind of were very different as chalk and cheese. And that geology explains much of the variation in ecology that we see. So looking in Britain, there's a sort of wishbone-like pattern of chalk with the Downs going across south of London, and then chalk going up northeast of London, up to East Anglia. And that wishbone pattern you can see in the distribution of many species. So there's some species, like many orchids, that like chalk. These are calcicoles, and they occur there. And there are other species of acid habitats that dislike chalk, you'll not see those there. And that geology will occur throughout the world in a whole range of different patterns with different rock types. So the geology is important, and the soil type is important. The third thing I want to talk about is the history of the site. So I'm here at Figsbury Rings, which seems to be a Neolithic and Bronze Age site. The history is a bit confusing, but you can see there's a bank that runs all the way around this site. And then in the center, there are ditches. There's a ditch that occurs. And this very much affects the ecology. The fact all this chalk has been dug up here produces this chalk-rich bank, which is fabulous for chalk vegetation. And this area has been cleared and grazed and farmed for thousands of years. So the history very much has influenced the ecology of the site. And then the final component I want to think about is the one that we're used to talking about, the regular issue of these videos, which is the ecology. So just as one example, one of the characteristic species you get here is the Adonis blue butterfly. And to protect that, you need to look after the horseshoe vetch that they lay their eggs on, and you need to look after the species of ants that the horseshoe that the Adonis blue tricks into getting them to look after their pupae, particularly some species like Myrmica sabulete, some of the species that like the dry habitats. So it's critical to get the grass height right, get the right habitats to attract the ants to enable the Adonis blue to survive. So if you're to understand ecology, you're to understand communities, as well as understanding the ecology, which is what we always talk about, it's really important to understand the underlying geology, the soil type, and the history of the location. Good luck.